GoPro Hero 6, frames per second. What is frames per second? Frames per second refers to the number of video frames that are captured in each second. The shortcut for frames per second is FPS. In your GoPro, frames per second is displayed as FPS. Options for this setting are 24, 30, 60, 120, and 240. The higher the frames per second, the smoother the motion and the smoother the slow motion. Lower frames per second result in greater detail and clarity but less captured motion. Higher frames per second result in less detail and clarity but more captured motion. When ProTune is on, the bitrate of the GoPro camera is about 45 megabits per second. The quality per frame can be calculated by the megabits per second divided by the frames per second. For example, 45 megabits per second divided by 60 frames per second gives each frame a quality of 0.75 megabits. 45 megabits per second divided by 30 frames per second gives each frame a quality of 1.5 megabits. The lower the frame rate, the higher the quality / details and clarity per frame. There are some basics about frames per second. 24 frames per second is used for cinematic storytelling. 30 frames per second is used for standard storytelling. 60 frames per second gives a more lifelike feeling. 60 frames per second is used to capture anything fast moving. 60 frames per second is also used to create slow motion. 120 frames per second is used to create super slow motion. 240 frames per second is also used to create super slow motion. What is the best FPS or what FPS should you use? That depends on the activity that you want to capture and what kind of video effect that you want to achieve. Two different frames per second. When creating a video, there are two different frames per second. The first frames per second is the frames per second that is set in your camera. This is the frames per second that you can select in your camera to shoot videos with. The second frames per second is the frames per second that you select as a sequence / timeline in your editing program to edit your videos with. I'm going to explain it. For example, when you are going to edit videos with an editing program, you must select a frames per second for your sequence / timeline. For example, you can choose to edit videos in an editing program that is based on 60 frames per second. When your videos are shot in 60 frames per second, this matches the setting of your editing program and your videos will look normal and the same way as the way you recorded it. But if you shot videos in 30 and 60 frames per second, there is a problem, because you can select only one frames per second setting in your editing program. Now there are two options. The first thing that you can do is select 60 frames per second for your editing program, but then the editing program is going to add 30 frames per second more to your videos that are shot in 30 frames per second, all by itself, so your 30 frames per second videos will match the 60 frames per second timeline setting of your editing program. But because your editing program added 30 frames per second that are fake, your video may look weird. The second thing that you can do is select 30 frames per second for your editing program, but then the editing program is going to delete 30 frames per second from your videos that are shot in 60 frames per second, all by itself, so your 60 frames per second videos will match the 30 frames per second timeline setting of your editing program. But because your editing program deleted 30 frames per second, your video may look weird. Because you can select only one frames per second setting in your editing program, it is impossible to do a frames per second comparison in one video. Because with different frames per second, your editing program will add or delete frames per second. But I still did some tests in different numbers of frames per second to give you a basic understanding and let you see what the difference in motion slash movement is. Congratulations! You now know more about the different frames per second of the GoPro Hero 6.